Record. I'm starting recording. Okay. So now we are going to see characteristics. Okay. So T code for characteristics is CT04. Okay. CT04. Transaction code characteristics is CT04.
Share your screen.
Oh, sorry. Hold on a second. So got my screen now.
Yeah.
Okay. So transaction code for characteristics is CT04. Okay, CT04. So now I'm going to create a characteristics for my mobile. I'm putting as mobile. Okay. Press enter or click this create button. This specs is display. Okay. This pin is change mode. Not here anywhere in SAP. If you see a specs, it is display. Okay, if you see a pin, you are going to edit it. And this button is the create button. Okay, this is template. Okay, leave it. So now we are going, you can press enter or you can click this button, anything you can do. SAP, again, I'm telling, if specs, it is display. Not here, anywhere. If you see that specs, it's a display. Pin is a edit mode. It will give, go for edit mode. So I'm pressing enter. It will give you a pop-up. Do you want to create characteristics? Yes, I want to create. Okay, description for mobile specifications. Okay, characteristics group. Anything related to mobile we will get? I don't think so. We'll see. Okay, let me keep as desktop PC as of now because I don't think so. Mobile will be here. PC accessories. PLM packages, pump resource. Not there. Okay. So let's keep as okay. PC. Okay. So important thing, the status should be released. If it is not in release stage, you cannot use these characteristics. Status should be in release stage. Please note in your hand note. Data type numeric. When you change this data type to numeric, this below will come. So number of characters, 8 characters, decimal places 2, unit of measure, your mobile, what is the unit of measure, we don't have. So take us a bike, your unit of measure will be kilometer. Okay, so kilometer. So this 8 and 2, what is the meaning? In the values tab, you will be entering your mobile specifications. So bike means kilometers, bike kilometer, 5,000 kilometer. Okay, so see, okay, it is taking 8 digits, 3, 6, 7, 8 digits. If you want to keep as decimal, you can add decimal here. Okay. So decimal you can keep 2 places decimal here. Okay, so one important thing in this characteristics, you should keep your unit of measure proper, because once you save it, after you come to change mode also, you cannot modify your unit of measure. Okay, so this is how to create a characteristics. This is the place where you are giving your values. Okay, so I'm saving this. Now see, I'm going in change mode. I'm going in change mode. Okay, yeah, correct. Here you can use, but if you use this in the next places, and once you save, then you cannot modify your measure. Correct. Here you can modify. Here you can modify your unit of measure. Okay. Okay, so this is just a description what we have given here. This description will come here. Okay, this is the place where you are going to give the values, and this we'll see later. This is okay. So any doubts, questions?
No.
Okay. So I'm saving this. Now I want to attach this mobile characteristics to my equipment, which is a mobile. Okay. Take any equipment. So how I can attach? See here, class overview. Okay. In the equipment master, go inside. There will be class type 002. Double click it. Okay. So this screen will come. So here the class is there. It's of class type 002. So go to T-code CL02. CL02. Transaction code CL02. Okay. So here the class type is 002. For that class type, take a class. Anything related to mobile won't be there. Let's see if anything related. Computer is there. Okay. Mobile won't be there. Okay, let's take that computer itself as of now, okay? Let's take as computer. So for this computer of class type, we are going to attach our characteristics, okay? This is already created, this class. Go to characteristics, give our mobile here. The characteristics which we created. Okay? Now save this. ITPL, this is for the class, okay, sorry. Okay, I am saving this. Actually, computer is the description, this is the class, okay. For this, the description is computer. Okay, so I am saving this. Now go to your equipment, /in, okay. IE02. Okay, go to class overview, class type 002, copy your class here. See your specification screen here. The value what we entered there. Got it?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Any questions? Any questions from any of you?
No.
Okay, so this is how to attach characteristics for the class. Actually, there are many in class and overview. Actually, it is more with related to MM, material management. From BM, it is not much more. If you know this, even I know this only. Actually, it's class and characteristics is a very big topic. From PM, this is what required, nothing much required. That's related to MM actually, not our PM. It's related to material management, but we need to know about this class and characteristics. Okay, so our value came here. So functional divide, you understand, right? What is class and characteristics? Hope I think so. Both of you, right? Nothing specifications, that's all. It's nothing but the specification of object. Any object. Motor means kilowatt. And bearing size. Yes, bearing size also you can create a specifications. You should create a characteristics of bearing size, bearings, and that characteristics to be attached to a class of class type 002, and you can have it. And pump, suction pressure, discharge pressure, and what are other things, pumps, that you can add. So any doubts in class and characteristics? I think no. So next we go for a measuring point and measurement document. So what is measuring point and what is measurement document? You have your pumps, motors. For example, in your room, you are in US, so you won't use AC. You'll be using heaters. So that heater, how much current it is taking, how much voltage it is taking, that in the stabilizer, that voltmeter might be there. That value, whether I can enter into SAP, yes, that value can be recorded into SAP. That value, what we are going to enter into SAP, is called the measurement document. That value is called the measurement document. What is measuring point? It is the place the point where you are going to take your read. It is the point location where you are going to take the reading. Any questions on what is measurement point and documents from both of you?
I didn't understand what is.
Okay, so you didn't understand, fine. Basically, okay, so you are doing MS. Before MS in degree, what you did degree in engineering or what you did?
Bachelor's in electrical engineering.
Okay, you are an electrical engineer, fine, very good. So, you know about motors, correct? What is a motor, you know? The motor, there will be some current, right?
Mm-hmm.
Each 2 hours, the business will be going and they will be checking the current. Example. So what they will do, that current they will be writing in the paper. Correct. If you go to process industry, they will do it. Each 2 hours, they need to go and take the readings and they will be writing the paper. Whether it is in the correct stable condition, whether the current is less or more, any abnormality is there. Abnormality is different, that keep that the other side, but the value they are taking, right, each 1 hour, 2 hour or 30 minutes once, that value they will be writing in the paper. Instead of writing in the paper, you can enter that into the SAP.
Yeah, okay,
got it. The value what you are going to enter is called the measurement document, the value. Point is the place where you are going to take that reading. This measurement document, where you are going to take it, at which point, that is this point. Clear?
Yeah, it's clear.
So why they kept this point? They can put directly to the equipment. For the equipment, I am creating document. Why I need this point? For that equipment, in some motors, they will have 2 or 3 voltage meters, 2 or 3 ammeters. For the same object, due to that only they are kept as measurement point. Otherwise, you did not want this measurement point at all. This document you can directly attach to the equipment. Since there would be more than one measurement object, I am telling example as voltage or current, it could be anything. Your pumps means discharge pressure, suction pressure, AC stabilizer, that is what I told you. Our refrigerator stabilizer, voltage, current. Like that, it goes on. Pipe vacuum pressure, pipe discharge pressure. Okay. Anything, any value that need to be recorded to SAP. Some values. Now you are something clear?
Yeah.
Okay. So let me create. So when I need to create this measurement, enter this measurement document before that measuring point to be created. Measurement point with which reference I will be created, I can create with equipment or functional question, both. For both, I can create measurement point. Okay. So let's see in the system how to create a measurement point. See, let's see here if measurement point is there. Here, no measurement point is there. So let me create a measurement point. Okay. For this equipment itself. Okay. T code to create measurement point is IK01. Give your equipment number. That is what I told. This measurement point you are going to create with reference to this equipment. If you want to create for functional location, change your measurement object. That's all. Functional location. For equipment or functional location, you can change. Since you change your measurement object, it is coming as functional location. Take any function. You can do for any, no matter. So press enter for motor. Okay. Motor number 25. Okay. Position 1. Okay. Give the characteristics we created now. Mobile. See here. This is what I told. Here you cannot modify your characteristics. That is what I told. While creating your characteristics CT04, you need to keep it, you need very carefully. because after using this in the machine pointer document, you cannot modify your characteristics here for your info.
Can you go back and change in the data?
Here you can change. In the characteristics, you can change. There you can go and change. Here you can go and modify. Here you can modify. But after this is entered, there you cannot modify. I'm telling you. Here you can modify. But just keep a note. That is what I'm telling you. One of the important, some key point you can tell. Two things here. One is status released and this unit of measure. These two you need to keep and remember. These two key points. They're important one and two key points, I'm telling you. Maybe if you are taking handwritten notes, that will be useful for you. It's your things. So, yeah. Okay, let me go there. Where are we now? Measuring point, yeah. So IQ01, okay. Slash in IQ01, okay. So, function location increment, anything you can do, okay. Press enter for motor number 25, position 1. Your characteristics here, okay. So what is target value? Target value is the constant, that is general value it will maintain. General value for motor, the volt current will be 50 amps generally. It could go up to 40 and it could come up to 55 to 60, but normal value is 50. That is what this target value. What is the normal value it will maintain? Okay. That is what ideal measurement reading for this measuring point. Ideal means normal value, not low, not high. Generally, what is the value? If it runs, what will be the, if you take us three-phase system, 420 volts voltage. So 420 volts is the target value. Okay, so this is the target value. So this measuring point for this motor, position one. Okay, this is one of the point one. Now I am going to create same another measurement point for the same function location. Motor 25, position 2. I hope now you understand what is measuring point. For same motor,
yeah,
another place I am taking the value. This is the reason they had kept something as measuring point. Point means it is not north, south, east, and west, not regular. Which point, which place? The instant, that is where it is seated, that object where it is seated. Okay, where your point, that value, that ammeter, voltmeter, where it is sitting. That's what I can tell, I think so. So I am saving this. Now there is another voltmeter. Okay. Position 3. That's all. You can save now. Okay, for this function location you are doing. Okay, for this function location I am saving. Go to your function location now. See here, we created three measuring points. This is measuring points. Still you didn't start your documents. This is only the point where you are going to take your readings. Okay, now I am going to enter measuring documents for this. Translation code is IK11. Okay, IK11. IK11. First value, I think so, it is 62, I think so. Yes, okay. So, we had entered the target value there. See, this is giving us reference for you. Normally, it should be 50. So what is the value now? 48 is my value. Okay, save this. For the same point, I'm entering next value, 51. Save this. For the same point, I'm entering next value, 45. Save this. Now I am going to enter value for the next measuring point. Next voltage. Okay. Here the value is 54. Save it. 55. Save it. So the last is the 64. Okay. 47, 46. 45. You can see your previous measurement document from this point. Previous measurement document, see here. 46 we entered last value. Not this value, the old value. All the values you can see here, last measurement documents. Your measuring point, press execute, only one value. Any doubts, questions in the screens, both of you?
No.
Banu, from your side?
No.
Okay, fine. So go to the function location now. Same for equipment, the same, no change. Go here, measurement points, and we'll see here. Select it, you go to the measurement document. Value. It's last, right? We'll get the full measurement documents here. Yes. Two values, three values added, 45, 48, and 51. Time, date, even time will come if you modify it. This change layout, current. Here, even if you see the time, where is the time? Measurement time, see. Even the time it will give with the seconds and other things. If you want to change it by, created by, readings taken by, okay, everything you can get from. See how many are there inside this itself. So much are there. Target value, what we saw, see here. Even if you want, you can bring it. Target value. See how much it is coming. So many data are there. It goes on. So much is there. So for this is for first point. Now we'll see for the second point. Measurement documents. Execute. See two values we had entered. Now the third point. Two values we had entered. Any doubt with respect to this measuring point and documents? Questions? Anything?
Actually, excuse me.
Yeah, tell me.
Do mean of the all the measurements?
No, I didn't get you.
After collecting all the measurements, will they do the mean?
Oh, okay. You want to do the mean value. Even I don't know if there is any option like that. Mean value here. Mean value, I don't think so.
Then what is the use of this data?
See, if you go to companies, they'll be writing in the note and paper and they will throw the paper. You need to keep the paper record safe. Then why SAP? Tell me. You tell me why SAP. Why you need to do maintenance in SAP? To have the old history, right?
Yeah.
That is what the same. If I want, I'm using SAP for 50, 20 years. I want to know before 10 years what current the same motor had taken.
Yeah, okay. Got it.
Our example, now there is a failure. Bearing failure, today it had happened. Same bearing failure happened 6 years before. Example, at that 6 years, you can get the date when that issue had happened. At that 6 years, what is the current it had taken last 1 week? Analysis, reporting, history.
Okay, got it.
Got me. Then SAP is not required, right? Then why we need to do maintenance in SAP? We can do in a paper and we can throw and go off. Right?
Yeah, that's
right. And also, no, nothing wrong what you're asking. I'm not telling anything. What your question is correct. Why you're asking, I need mean value. Mean value, they are not given any Anything? I don't think so. Mean value, any option is there in measurement point? I don't think so. I don't think so. Any mean value can be taken. I am not sure. I am not here till day. No, mean value is not there. As I know. Why I am thinking SAP is big ocean. Maybe that also would be there in SAP. Who knows? But no, I know mean value is not there. Don't worry. Okay. And also through this measurement point and document, you can do performance for your bike. That is preventive topic. We'll be seeing it later. Okay. Your bike you are running. How you will maintain your bike in a good condition? Tell me.
Analysis.
Sorry?
By analyzing.
Okay. Other ways.
Checking.
That is what checking when you will do. Analysis and checking, what daily will you get time to do it? No.
When you feel it's not in a position, good condition.
When it is not in good condition, that is kind of repair.
Mm-hmm.
When doing repair, that is not performance. Even when it is working correctly, you will be doing preventive measure. Whether it is running or not, my bike, 6 months means 6 months, I will do a performance. I will do a service. That is what suggested by the manufacturer. Got me?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But their date is coming. Here date, not date. Your running hours or your bike kilometer. You had bought a bike as Bajaj or Suzuki Samurai. They are told, boss, each 200 kilometers do a service. Each 200 kilometers do a service. That can be done through this performance. So, you got me what I'm telling?
Mm-hmm.
You're able to understand what I'm about to tell? It doesn't check the dates. It checks only the kilometers. If your 2000 is taking 10 years, it won't see it is taking 10 years. It will wait till it comes 2000 kilometers. If the 2000 is coming within 2 months, it will ask you to do a performance. Boss reached 2000. Because 2000 is suggested by the manufacturer. Got me?
Yeah, got it.
That is a separate topic. That is coming through this measuring point. That we'll see. Not a big thing, but before that, we need to know preventive topic on that. Then only we can see that. Okay, so any questions on this two? Class and characteristics and measurement documents. Any questions?
No.
Fine. So this two is preventive process that we'll see later. Okay. Now we have our labors to do our maintenance. We have our objects, that is our motor, pump, machines, welding machine, crane, hoist, anything, your TV, refrigerator, your bike, anything that will be created as object. And I have my material to carry my maintenance. So I need to start my maintenance activities. So maintenance activities is called in SAP as what? Work order process. Or maintenance order they will tell. Order in PM, in material management also order is there, that is purchase order is related to MM. Okay, so don't think if order it is PM. Okay, purchase order they will tell us PO. It is MM, not our PM module. This is related to our MM module, not our separate module. Our maintenance carried as work order process. Whatever we had seen till now, what and all we are going to see till our session is going to see, not today, full module. Finally, everything come and enter in this work order process. Because this is the step-by-step of maintenance process in SAP. Got what is maintenance process, work order process?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, first, create work order. Maybe I think we can close this section and we'll start a new session because this is work order process, not to have interruption. We will close the session. I will start a new session immediately. Okay. Banu, you are there?
Yeah, okay.
Banu is there?
Yeah, we'll open it again.
Because we'll have a work order in a fresh one, not to be here and there off. Let me close this and I will join the new meeting again.